Hi everyone, another video here on how to customize your home screen. I found out an amazing app that makes your widgets look transparent and your home screen to look more clear and aesthetic and beautiful. So in this video, I will show you how to use this app step by step. There are some tips you need to know, so watch till the end, and if you're ready, let's start. The app I'm gonna use is called Widgetopia, and what it does is to help you create calendar widgets, daytime, weather widgets, and this kind of widgets. But if you tap the three dots and go to settings, it has an option to make your widgets look transparent. Now, the app gives some instructions, and if you read them and follow them, the process will be super easy. What it says is to go on your home screen, go on jiggle mode and swipe right until you find a blank page. Then take a screenshot and then return back to the Widgetopia app, select and upload this screenshot, and you are halfway there. Then go back to the main menu of the app and tap to create a new widget in the size you want. In this example, I will create a small widget of the date. This is free to use, and for this reason you can make many changes, but I like how it looks on my home screen anyway. When you finish, it's time to add your new widget to your home screen. Repeat the usual process to add your new widget, and now your home screen should look like this. The next and the final step is to change this black background and set it as a transparent. Just tap on the widget and tap edit widget, and from here enable the transparency button, and the most crucial part is to set right the background position. Tap choose, and because we want the widget to be on the top left corner, we will tap on the top left. I will go back to my home screen to see if everything looks fine. A quick note here, the first time I used the app, I had to repeat the process again and again because the background didn't look good and the background position was wrong, but now it works fine. For example, I chose a wrong background position to show you how it looks when the position is wrong. I will set it back to transparent again, and you can repeat the same process to add more widgets, more transparent widgets on your home screen, just repeating the same steps. Basically, that's it. You can stop here and download the app to use it on your phone, but I will give you some extra tips to save you time and make your life a little bit easier. First, I have to warn you that the app has too many ads, which of course I have removed from this video, but I think it still is worth it. Secondly, the free options are really limited, and all the cool stuff, the colorful ones, the weather, the calendar, are on the paid option. I still use the free option and I'm pretty happy with the result, but I think if you think you're gonna use it, then it's not too expensive. Also, a really cool feature that I really liked is that you can create your own widgets. The same goes here, the free version has limited options, but I liked and I created this battery icon for my home screen. I chose the icon and I only made two changes. I resized it a little bit and I changed the rotation because I liked it a little bit more this way. And that's it, you have a new widget. I also created the widget for the steps, but keep in mind here that it didn't work really well at first. I had to refresh it a few times in order to refresh the steps of the new day. And also remember to keep the numbers and the letters small, because you will end up with something like this. And finally, let's see what's gonna happen if you have followed all these steps and you have created many widgets, but you have changed your mind and you want to change the background. As you can see, if I only change the background, the widgets will have the previous background and this won't look beautiful. And to fix this, you just need to repeat only the first part of the process and that is to go on jiggle mode, swipe right, take a screenshot, and then go back on the Widgetopia app and upload the screenshot. Now everything looks fine again, and I really loved how it turned out and the final outcome. Comment below if you liked it too and use it on your iPhone. That's it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching and see you on the next video. Bye!